So the next chapter talks about DNA technology. So the use of technology to manipulate DNA. Because we hear, what do you hear about DNA? Why is DNA manipulated? Anything, have you ever heard anything at all?
Cloning.
Cloning, what is cloning?
Making an exact replica.
Cloning is one. Okay, so have you heard, have you ever eaten anything that where the DNA is modified?
GMOs.
GMOs, genetically modified organisms. So pretty much all crops that we can consume nowadays, you know, soybean and corn and cotton or anything, rice, wheat, anything is genetically modified. So that's why they are called GMOs. And GMOs, genetically modified organisms, is a kind of an umbrella term which is used to describe any organism, plants or animals that have been modified in any way. One of the example of a GMO is the production of insulin. Insulin is produced in bacteria. So human insulin that people who are diabetic consume is produced in bacteria. That bacteria is an example of a GMO. It's a genetically modified bacteria that has a foreign gene in it. So all the genes in bacteria are the same, except they have introduced a foreign gene that is taken from humans, inserted in bacteria, and they grow them in thousands and thousands of liters in fermenters, and then they extract insulin from it. So that's what makes actually people survive who are diabetic. If insulin is not provided to them, they cannot survive without insulin. They will survive for some period of time, and then after that, their body will not be able to function because insulin is critical for the survival. And then we also hear about, you know, some crops. Have you ever heard about the crops that are resistant to sprays, like you can actually spray Roundup. What is Roundup? Have you ever used any Roundup? It kills any vegetation, right? Whether those are weeds or non-weeds. So there are crops that have been produced where you spray Roundup on them and nothing will happen to them. So meaning that they have a gene which make them resist being killed by Roundup, which is a weedicide, which is just not only a weedicide, actually, it just is a chemical that destroys all the plants, grasses, and but in those crops that have been created with resistant gene in them, Roundup does not work on them. So that is another example of GMO. So it makes life of the farmers easy because when you grow those crops and then you spray those crops with weedicides, the crops will survive and all the weeds will be killed. So, and then there are other examples, like, you know, you gave the example of cloning. Cloning, for example, cattle. The meat that is produced comes from those animals that have been cloned. So meaning that those have been produced in test tubes. So not actually going through the normal process of sexual reproduction, but they have been produced in test tubes now. So those are also examples of genetically modified, because the process in that case is very different. So DNA manipulation is being done and has been done actually for many decades now. That helps us to do some genetic testing, like, you know, we hear about paternity testing or inheritance of, in some cases, of criminal investigations and forensic analysis, or some crops has been modified in such a way that they have more muscles in them. Some animals have been created which are very muscular so that we can actually get more meat from them, or there are some fish that have been produced which are much larger than the normal fish. Those are genetically modified also. So a lot of medicines, a lot of drugs are being produced that way, legal, illegal, both actually, unfortunately. And drought and insect tolerance is being created in the crops. So the genes are inserted in crops and they become resistant to insects. So you can actually spray them with insects and they'll still be happy. So actually insects die. There are crops that are made now through this DNA technology that have genes from bacteria in them. So when insects attack them, they eat only like few minutes or so, and then they die. Because there is a gene in them that when it goes in the guts of those worms, those caterpillars, it kills them. So those are genetically modified. So the crops have been created that can be grown in conditions of drought, like in Africa, in Asia, where water is actually not that commonly available for crops. So it is those crops are very helpful because they can withstand lack of water for longer period of time. So there are many different tools that people are using to manipulate DNA, to take DNA from one place and take it somewhere else. So in case of insulin gene, which is actually an interesting example, it was done back in 1981. So what they did was they took a gene from humans. So genes in case of humans are located on chromosomes. So they isolated that gene. And then from bacteria, some bacterial DNA, there are two types of DNAs in bacteria. This one is their genomic DNA, which is circular. And then they also have this DNA, which is called, anybody knows what these DNAs are called in bacteria?
Plasmid.
These are called plasmids. So this plasmid DNA, what they did was, they took that DNA from humans, which is insulin gene. And then they inserted that small DNA, they removed this one from bacteria. When it came outside, they cut it with an enzyme, and they took this DNA and inserted here. So let's make it a little different color. And then inserted it in here, and then put it back inside bacteria. Once it was inside bacteria and bacterium, then it continued to multiply. So this insulin gene that was in humans was moved into plasmid, and from plasmid it went back inside bacteria and bacterium, and then they grew this bacterium multiple times, in very large volumes, in thousands and thousands of liters. So when it was grown like that, so this continued to be reproduced. So a large amount of bacteria, large number of bacteria and amount of bacteria was produced, and all of them had this insulin gene in it. They had this gene in it that continued to produce insulin protein. So this insulin protein can be isolated from them, can be purified and used for humans. So this was the very first application of this technology, DNA technology, that was introduced back in 1981. It was done in 1981, and it is still being used the same way today. All insulin that is being produced the same way that was done, that many years ago. And these are some of those tools that people, or some of these tools actually, most of these tools are very new tools that people introduced at that time. And those tools are called recombinant DNA. So recombinant means kind of combining two different things together. Recombining, recombination means putting two things together. Two things which are different from each other or from two different sources are put together in order to make this new type of DNA together. So that is called recombinant DNA technology. Then DNA sequencing, you probably have heard a lot about DNA sequencing. DNA sequencing is a technique in which the order of DNA sequence or order of DNA is determined. Your chromosomes are made of DNA. So, and chromosomes are long strands of DNA. So when you determine the order of DNA, that is called DNA sequencing. So if you have a chromosome, which is this long, and you determine that starting from here, it is A, C, G, T, T, C, G, and all those millions and millions of base pairs, that is called DNA sequencing. Then polymerase chain reaction, is amplification of DNA. It is increase in the number of DNA in such a way that from a single copy of DNA, thousands of copies of DNA are synthesized. So if you find a fragment of DNA in PCR, which is called polymerase chain reaction, so it is a reaction just like DNA replication. So DNA replication that takes place inside the cell, scientists modified that technique to do the same thing which is done naturally inside the cells in vitro or in test tubes. So a single strand of DNA is taken and then it is replicated multiple times. In each round, the number of DNA that is formed is double than the previous one. So it increases exponentially. It is an exponential increase in the amount of DNA. So each round of replication makes twice the number of DNA compared with the previous round of DNA. So from one copy becomes 2 to 4 to 8 to 16, 32, and it continues to increase like that. That is called polymerase chain reaction. Then the other thing is are these two things, stem cell research. So stem cells are naturally formed cells that are present in every organism, including humans. There are two types of stem cells. Stem cells are the ones that give rise to all cells of our body. So in the embryo, after the zygote, embryo that results from that zygote contains some stem cells in it. And those stem cells make the entire body. So it knows the structure of the entire body that is formed from the stem cells. Our brain has stem cells. Our muscles have stem cells. Our kidney cells have stem cells. So all cells of our body have stem cells. In case of embryos, embryos have stem cells also. So those stem cells give rise to all the tissues of our body because they know how to build those things. And embryonic stem cells were controversial because those were taken from embryos and people thought that, you know, we are killing babies. Because if those embryos are allowed to continue to exist, they can become babies and that can survive. So then this type of profiling or testing is done to find or to in forensic analysis. People actually do those analyses to find out who committed a crime. A lot of times a single hair or some skin cells are found in the nails at the place of the crime scene. So those are enough to find out who committed the crime. And this type of techniques are very powerful techniques because a lot of people who were implicated and have been actually arrested and have been thrown in the jails were exonerated based on these techniques. And somebody who were found guilty based on the evidence or whatever 30 years ago, 40 years ago, these type of techniques have help them to be released from the prisons because they did not commit those crimes. And now because the DNA testing is available, so when those tests were done on the evidence that was provided, so they were released from the prisons. So it is a lot of these things are done by scientists, by biotechnologists that are quite familiar with DNA and different and the manipulation of DNA. So they use a lot of different techniques to do those type of things. You might have seen some of these fish in Walmart and other places. You know, they are very cheap. You know, they cost about $5. These are normal fish. And the only thing which is different in these fish is that they have just a single gene which is different in them. The gene has been taken from sea anemone. Sea anemone are naturally glowing under dark. So they glow under dark, like jellyfish also. So jellyfish also kind of shines, it gives a color. So what they have done is that they took that gene from sea anemone and inserted in these fish, which were, you know, selling for less than $1. So they glow under dark. They have, you know, red colors or purple colors or blue color. Otherwise, they are just normal fish. That were available. There's, you know, some of these orange fish or those golden fish. So now they glow in many different colors. So these look really different, you know, pretty or I don't know. They look different than the other ones, and then they glow under dark also, which makes them look really pretty. So these are transgenic organisms. These are GMOs. These are transgenic organisms, in which transgenic means that they have a gene. Transgenic means no gene has been transferred in them. A gene is taken from somewhere else and has been inserted in the genome of these organisms. So transgenic is a name. GMO is the same thing. These are genetically modified organisms, and transgenic. Transgenic means that these are organisms who have a gene transferred in them. So the gene has been brought from somewhere else, like sea anemone, and inserted in them. Otherwise, they are just normal. They have nothing else which is different than the normal ones. But they look different, and they look, in some cases, kind of pretty. These are some other examples. A lot of animals are transgenic. Insulin is produced in transgenic organisms. Cattle, rice. Rice actually has a deficiency in it. It's not a complete diet. So the people who eat rice, like a lot of people actually in Asia do that, they actually develop certain diseases because rice is not a complete diet and it has something missing. So what scientists have done is they have taken the natural rice and have modified that rice with some transgenic genes, or some genes which kind of complements and completes and makes it more healthy rice now. So I think that's, we still have a little bit of time. Okay, so transgenic organisms are produced this way. What time do we finish it? 35. Oh, okay. Let's stop it. No, how do we stop it?